when I was little, instead of getting bedtime stories, my dad used to give me a math problem that I had to figure out.
I wanted to be an astronaut. I was just drawn to the adventure of it.
I'm from Roundup, Montana, and there's 38 kids in my high school class.
I was this huge nerd in high school.
I was always really interested in this sci-fi vision of robots.
My name is Jenny Sue Hain. I am from Fort Shaw, Montana, and my goal is to design robots and spacecraft.
I'm going to design buildings for the third world.
I'm going to build better roads and bridges.
I'm studying industrial engineering to work in disaster relief.
And we're going to be physicians.
So I always knew I wanted to go into science.
Probably halfway through high school, I started looking into forensic science, and then that kind of just led into med school in general.
I decided when I was 18 that I wanted to study industrial engineering.
I was never quite sure what I wanted to be when I grew up.
It took a lot of courage, actually. You sort of grow into really relishing in your geekiness. So I could say, okay, I am really into math and science, and that's okay and that's cool because that's who I am.
This is the prototype of a robot that we're designing to be able to dig dirt on the moon.
I love architecture for so many reasons, but since starting college, I've been able to travel to Kenya, working with a local Kenyan architect and doing third world aid and designs, and it's totally invaluable and totally relevant.
Today, I just had an in-class project and I had to do a construction plan for a house using the computer, and I wish I could make that become something out there in the real world.
I started shadowing doctors and I started working at the hospital.
Right.
Especially like emergency medicine, I'm kind of an adrenaline junkie.
I got to see a lot of emergencies and a lot of really unexpected and tricky situations.
I've just seen more of the humanistic side of it and just been like, there are people who seriously need help and I can do that. I can offer hope to somebody who has no hope. That first high school science teacher I had was the first one who made me realize, like, there are no boundaries. You can do whatever you want.
My name's Amy Washtek. I'm a science teacher at Bozeman High School. This is the biomedical sciences class. It is a class designed to get students interested in healthcare vocations and careers in science.
I want to be a microbiologist. I want to be a neonatal surgeon.
I want to be a neurosurgeon.
I want to be a food scientist.
I want to be a microbiologist engineer.
I want to be an orthopedic surgeon.
I want to be a heart surgeon.
I want to be a cardiac nurse specialist.
Something that really helped me in those times was to look up and find mentors who had already gone through it. And I still rely on those people that I met when I was 15 and 16 years old who said, engineering's great, or what you want to pursue is fantastic. It's definitely doable.
I was probably one of three girls in the class, and that hasn't changed all through high school and then through college as well.
I guess I've never thought that being surrounded by men was a big deal.
And there's this part of me that says I have something to prove, but there's another part of me that thinks, okay, I'm up to the challenge.
I guess I just had to think about it a lot on my own and figure out why I was different and if the things that made me different were really important to me. And so I realized that I didn't want to lose those things, and that was an important part of who I was. And so I guess just realizing that it's okay to be different, and I think if you realize it, then the people around you will also learn to respect it.
If you know that you love to do something, I would stick with it, even if you're a girl who loves math.
If you really want to do something you're passionate about, then you got to stick it out and you got to just not give up on that.
I hope that people jump in with both feet and really look around to see what's out there.
It's always daunting that you're afraid that the next step you might take might be a failure. But take it anyway and go after what your dream is. You can achieve it.
When you have flown, you will walk the earth with your eyes turned skyward. For there you have been, there you long to return.